What you see back there is the Bambu Lab P1S right beside the brand new Bambu Lab P2S. I have both machines here, and what I'm going to do today is show you the differences and similarities between the two machines, and then talk to you as one business owner to possibly another one, whether or not it makes sense for you to purchase the P2S combo, or should you stick with the tried and true P1S. Hey guys, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. That's right, today's video is going to be all about 3D printing and specifically the Bambu Lab P1S combo versus the Bambu Lab P2S combo and whether or not it makes sense from a business perspective to purchase and spend a little bit more for that P2S. As we get into this video, I want to be very clear and upfront, Bambu Lab is not sponsoring this video. Instead, Jackery's sponsoring it, but I'll talk more about that later. So this is going to be a completely unbiased, regular guy view of both machines with no strings attached, ties, or favors given to Bambu Lab. That being said, let's go ahead and jump into the differences between the two machines. So what I want to do first is run through the main differences between the P1S combo and the P2S combo in case you're not familiar with them and you just want the meat and taters of it, of what's the difference, A and B. Don't tell me everything that's alike, what's different? Let's start off with the displays because that is one big difference between the two machines. On the P1S, you have a non-touch screen, single color LCD display of about 854 pixels by 480. You then have knob buttons and physical buttons to interact with, and that's about it. By far, it's been one of the things that's kind of lacked with the P1S, especially as 3D printers have evolved over time and gotten better. This is one that's always kind of dated the P1S. In contrast, the P2S has a beautiful 5-inch full-color touchscreen display with a resolution of 720 pixels by 1280 and includes the intuitive user interface that we have seen on the H2S, H2D, H2C, a little bit of the A1, but it's a different flavor, and even the X1 Carbon series. Finally, the P2 is part of the crew with a nice touchscreen, and it really makes a big difference for your day-to-day user interface and ease of use without any other machines, computers, slicers needed right there on the printer. That touchscreen really does make a big difference. As far as the extruder or tool head, the P1S is rocking the standard one that we've all been used to, but the P2S has the new DynaSense servo extruder, which is advertised with having 70% more extrusion force, a quick swap nozzle, and real-time error detection through their software. The P2S nozzle is better for high-flow printing. It gives you fewer clogs and has easier maintenance. That being said, the P1S nozzle configuration, everything is rock solid. It's been out there for a long time. There's thousands and thousands of hours on the original nozzles out there, so I don't think that the P1S is a bad system. It's just they have improved it with the P2S. As far as the cooling system, the P1S has its extruder fan, of course, but also the fan to the left of your print bed for part or bed cooling as needed. But the P2S has what Bambu Lab calls the adaptive airflow, which automatically adjusts for fresh air intake, allows your doors to be closed for more materials, and generally gives you better temperature control within the cabinet. More precise temperature control inside your cabinet. Generally, it gives you an improved print quality, allows you to use more technical engineering filaments, things well beyond just PLA or PETG, and definitely is something that if you look to needing those advanced filaments, you're really going to want to have. Another really big difference between the two models is their interior lighting and built-in camera. Looking at the P1S, the lighting exists and the camera is there, but it has always been a little lackluster. There's a whole world of accessories and add-ons or mods that people have done to improve the lighting inside the P1S. Thankfully for the P2S, Bambu Lab has addressed that. They have given you more lighting and a really, really good onboard camera. While the camera and lighting doesn't really mean much for business, the P2S uses your camera along with its AI for an AI error detection. What this does is it can pause and alert you if it notices any kind of failures automatically. This is something we previously only saw with the X1 Carbon series, but of course we also have it with the H2 series. So seeing that Bambu Lab included it with the P2S was a very good thing. So from that standpoint, the AI detection is beneficial for your business, so that camera does actually make a difference too. The P1S, when it first came out, advertised carbon rods for your extruder's movement, which honestly sounds really cool. However, with extended use, those carbon rods tend to need a little more maintenance than just your plain old-fashioned metal ones. Thankfully, with the P2S, they've just put metal ones in there to keep it simple, to make your maintenance easy and carefree, and keep your print quality as good as possible. That's not a huge difference, but it is one that is there that is worth noting. Now let's talk about pricing, but definitely I want to disclaimer this with understand that things are going to change, prices are going to change as time goes on, so the numbers I quote you today may not even be relevant when this video publishes. All the same, you're going to be curious, so I'll give you the information as of right now. Currently, the P1S combo with just the original AMS, not the AMS 2 Pro, which Bambu Lab offers as an optional upgrade package, just the AMS and the P1S is right at $549. The P2S combo, which is only available with the AMS 2 Pro, is selling for $799 currently. Again, prices are going to change, sales will happen, and who knows, honestly, how long the P1S is going to be out there and available for purchase, but right now, those are the price differences between the two. Speaking of the AMS versus AMS 2 Pro, that is another big difference between the two machines. While you can still purchase the P1S with the AMS 2 combo at this time, what I want to talk about is the differences between the original AMS and the AMS 2 Pro, in case you're looking at the two wondering what the difference is and if it's really worthwhile to spend the extra for the AMS 2 Pro. The original AMS has been out there for many years and is a tried, tested, and true system, but it is not without its problems. It does not give you very easy access to the underside for maintenance, especially with those PTFE tubes. If you have a clog, a filament break, or need to get in there, it has been notoriously difficult to do. Thankfully, the AMS 2 Pro addressed that and gives you easy access to the bottom for maintenance, cleaning, and general upkeep of the system. Another big difference between the AMS and AMS 2 Pro is that the AMS 2 Pro has heating or filament drying built in. The original AMS doesn't. It's just a box. Whether this is a big benefit for you or not is definitely something you're going to have to weigh on your own. It depends upon your filament, it depends upon your environment, and it depends upon how fast you run through filament. For me and my business, my shop, the entire building here is dehumidified. It keeps an extremely low relative humidity, so I don't necessarily need a dry box to store filament in. It's also how I get away with storing filament open on shelves and not having problems with moisture accumulating or collecting in them. I also run through the process of drying my filament when I open it before it gets loaded into a machine. For that, I use a commercial food dehydrator. It holds about 24 kilograms in a single batch, and I've been using it for over a year with zero issues. I'm probably a little bit different use case though. If you're just looking at the machine itself and needing drying capabilities, it definitely makes sense and is attractive that the AMS 2 Pro has all that included. So I don't want to sell it short or act like it's not a great benefit, because it really is. The other difference between the AMS and AMS 2 Pro is very small, but it is there, and that is the ease of loading and the sound level. The AMS 2 Pro seems a lot easier to load filament. It can be done one-handed without much trouble. Also, the AMS 2 Pro seems quieter to me as far as loading filament and retracting it when it's done for color changes. In the grand scheme of a print farm, quiet doesn't really matter much, but it's something I've noticed that I did want to point out to you in case you're using these in a small office, in your home, or somewhere where noise does matter. Another difference between the two machines is in the initial power consumption when you first start a print job related to heating the build plate. The P1S does the heating as a very gradual, long process. Well, okay, not really long, but you know what I'm saying, slow and steady. The P2S, by contrast, is hot and heavy. It uses a lot more electricity on that initial heating, but it doesn't last as long. Where this will come into play is if you have multiples of these units connected to a single outlet or circuit in your home, and if you run the risk of tripping your breaker by starting them all at the same time. Depending upon the UPS you have your printers connected to, because again, you have them connected to a UPS, right? This may or may not be an issue, because your UPS may absorb that load demand and not push it onto your home's electrical system. However, it is worth pointing out that the P2S initially uses more electricity than the P1S, so if you have limited electrical supply in your space, it's something you definitely want to take into consideration. All right, you still with me? Because that could have been boring, but I wanted to throw all the bullet points at you and the major differences between the two machines first thing. As mentioned in the beginning of this video is sponsored by Jackery, so now is that time where we show Jackery some love as a thanks for helping support this channel and bring this content to you. For the entire duration of this video, both of these 3D printers have been powered by the Jackery Home Power 3600 Portable Power Station. This is a power station that packs big power, bigger capacity in a small portable package while still giving you the option to expand it if you need. This particular unit has a maximum output of 3600 watts, which means it will run both of these printers even through their heating cycles with no problems at all, with plenty of power to spare. And that big battery inside at over 3500 watt hours means that we can power these printers for a very long time as well. Outside of just battery backup, this Home Power 3600 also acts as a seamless UPS or uninterruptible power supply. I did a separate video kind of showing this with the H2 series 3D printer, and it is absolutely flawless. When connecting and disconnecting grid power input to the battery, it never shows it and never makes a difference on your printers. That is perfect because having every single 3D printer connected to a UPS is one of the things I consider vital and critical with any kind of 3D printing. Even if you're doing this as a hobby, you really want to have constant, continuous, clean power to your machines, of which the Jackery gives you with no problems. The power station has an assortment of 12-volt ports, such as USB-A, USB-C, and gets you covered anything electronic-wise for charging on that side. And then over to the right, it has your standard 120-volt, 20-amp max regular receptacles, along with a 30-amp RV port connection as well. Should you need any kind of power, this machine's got it right there, right up front. This unit also has ultra-low self-discharge, meaning if I charge it to 100% today, unplug it, turn it off, stick it on a shelf, it will sit there and lose no more than 5% of its battery life per year in storage, which means this guy will be ready for emergencies whenever I need it. I don't have to worry about charging it periodically, leaving it plugged up all the time. It can sit there and be ready when a need arises, and that is really cool. If you're in the market for a power station or want to see all of Jackery's offerings, there'll be a link to it down below. Thanks again to Jackery for sponsoring this video. But now let's get back to comparing the two 3D printers to each other. Now let's go ahead and put the meat and taters of the video and get our boots on the ground as far as print quality. I want to pick a file, I want to print it on the P1S, print it on the P2S, and see the differences between the two. Because honestly, that's one of the biggest things you're probably going to want to look at. Is there a quality difference? Do all the bells and whistles in the P2S really end up giving you a print that is visibly or tangibly improved? Or are they just bullet points on a piece of paper? Our little torture test print job has finished on both printers, and here is the outcome. At first glance, you probably couldn't tell which machine did which, but that's exactly what we would expect, or hope for at least, since these are both P-Series printers from Bambu Lab. They're both using the same exact print profiles, no calibration performed, these are straight out of the box settings, and they're both using Bambu Lab PLA Basic filament. To completely nitpick the two of them, the P1S is just a little bit behind the P2S when it comes to quality with this one print. The bridging did a little bit better on the P2S than it did on the P1S, and that really skinny spike also printed better. Outside of those two points, these two tests honestly look pretty much identical. The top layer quality is exactly the same. Looking at the bottom layer quality, exactly the same there as well. As far as any kind of seams, infill, finish quality, it all honestly looks the same. So on this one test, the P2S does win, but it wasn't by a landslide. It was only by a couple of strings on the bridging and a point. But hey, P2S, good job. We all hoped that you would win in this case anyway, didn't we? I know I did. Differences aside, there are a lot of similarities between the P1S combo and the P2S combo, because they're still P-Series printers. The print plates, identical. The overall footprint, very, very close. There's a little differences as far as height. The P2S is just a little bit taller. And the other difference is the auxiliary spool holder. It's on the back of the P1S, but on the side of the P2S. Outside of that, physically, unless you are in some super tight constraints as far as fitting your printer into a space, you don't have to worry about either one of these. Other similarities are going to be with your print speed. While one may advertise faster, in real life, they all print at the same speed because you don't print for speed, you print for quality. At least you should. So from that aspect, I view those two in the exact same light as well. Outside of those, you can just tell from the footage and everything that they are similar machines. Sure, there's differences here and there aesthetically or physically, but overall, the main differences are in the bullet points that I listed and more of the technical things versus the physical build quality or appearances of the printers. I don't like telling you guys what to do with your money, so this section is going to be very subjective because this section is all about should you buy the P1S or should you buy the P2S. Honestly, that's going to depend. First of all, I don't know how long Bambu Lab is going to keep the P1 series out there and available. So depending upon when you view this video, you may not have a choice. Outside of that, let's go ahead and assume that the P1S is always forever going to be there. The cost differences between the two is around, what, $250? $250 is not no amount of money, but if you're looking at a business investment, considering it to last several years, it's a little bit of an easier pill to swallow. That's also going to tie into what your use case or intended use is going to be for your 3D printer. Are you looking to buy 10 or 20 for a farm? Or are you looking to buy one for your office because you like to do this from a hobby? I would say if you're looking to buy for a farm, definitely weigh the needs. Do you need the AMS 2 Pro with the built-in heating and filament drying? Or do you, like me, dehumidify your space so this becomes your dry box? Also look at your power consumption requirements. Are you in an area where you don't have a lot of power supply and those P2Ss may run the risk of tripping your breakers? Maybe the P1S is right for you. On the opposite spectrum, maybe you do need those features of the AMS 2 Pro. Well, okay, you can get the AMS 2 Pro with the P1S. So then you gotta look at the differences of the printer. See how this gets complicated and see why I don't like to give recommendations? It's because we're all different. My use cases, my needs are different from yours and is different from everyone else out there. Either way, that's gonna be it for this video. The comparison between the Bambu Lab P1S combo and the Bambu Lab P2S combo. If you guys got any questions or comments, leave them for me down below. Otherwise, thanks for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys next time in the workshop. Oh yeah, elephant in the room. Sam shows a video making a 3D print farm, but no 3D printers are running. It's shift change, guys. As soon as this camera stops, all these guys are getting kicking because, you know, they need unloaded, filament needs refilled, and it's a lot quieter to film with them off.